apparatus that uses a dispersing system like a prism or a diffracting grating in order to separate light to observe the monochromatic lights forming it. When light falls on a prism, it undergoes refraction, so light is dispersed or separated into its constituent wavelength. When light falls on a diffracting grating, it undergoes diffraction, so light is separated or dispersed. Now, I want to use this simple spectroscope in order to observe the emission spectrum of an element. The emission spectrum of an element is the set of wavelengths that constitute the radiation emitted by this element when it is excited. Here we have a slit. Light entering the slit passes through the spectroscope to the diffracting grating located in the eyepiece. Now, I want to observe the emission spectrum of white light. This is a flashlight. It emits white light. Now, what do we observe when we let the light coming from the flashlight pass through the slit of the spectroscope? We observe a continuous band of colors without dark lines. This spectrum is called continuous emission spectrum. Now, let me show you the discrete emission spectrum. Here is a gas discharge lamp. It is a hydrogen gas tube. Now, what do we observe when we let the light coming from the hydrogen gas passing through the slit of our spectroscope? We observe discrete bright lines on a dark background. This emission spectrum is called discrete or discontinuous emission spectrum.
Now, let's summarize what we have seen in the previous experiment. The emission spectrum of an element is the set of wavelengths that constitute the radiation emitted by this element when it is excited. Depending on the source, we define two kinds of emission spectra. Let's start with the continuous emission spectrum. In this diagram, the light emitted from the glowing solid, such as tungsten filament in a dark room, falls on a prism. This light emerges from the prism, separated or dispersed, and falls on a screen. The spectrum is a continuous band of colors without dark lines. This spectrum is called continuous emission spectrum. When heated, gases under high pressure, solids, and liquids have continuous spectra of light. Also, the sunlight and the light emitted by an incandescent lamp contain all the visible wavelengths.
Let's move to the discrete emission spectrum. In a dark room, the light emitted from a glowing gas under low pressure falls on a prism. This light emerges from the prism separated or dispersed and falls on a screen E. The spectrum is a set of discrete bright lines on a dark background. This spectrum is called discrete or discontinuous emission spectrum or line emission spectrum. A gas under low pressure emits polychromatic light composed of selected wavelengths characteristic of the gas. Then, each gas has its own set of spectral lines.
This figure shows the line emission spectrum of hydrogen. We observe four spectral lines. Now, the figure shows the line emission spectrum of the mercury. It includes many spectral lines. Also, this figure shows the line emission spectrum of neon, and we have many spectral lines.
Focus, please. This is important.
Now, we are going to use Bohr model in order to explain the existence of the bright lines in the discrete emission spectrum. This is the energy level diagram of a hypothetical atom. Using Bohr model, we can conclude that each bright line in the emission spectrum corresponds to a wavelength of a certain photon emitted by the atom when decayed from a higher energy level to a lower energy level. For example, when the atom makes a downward transition from the energy level E3 to the energy level E2, it emits a photon of a frequency nu 1. And when it makes a downward transition from E5 to E3, it emits another photon of frequency nu 2. And during the transition from E4 to E2, it emits a photon of frequency nu 3. Similarly, from E2 to E1, emits another photon of frequency nu 4. The energy of the atom is quantized. Only selected values of energy are allowed. Then, only selected photons can be emitted by this atom, as shown in this emission spectrum. Therefore, the emission spectrum is discrete.
Let's move to the absorption spectrum. In a dark room, we direct intense white light, which contains all the visible wavelengths, on a gas, sodium vapor, or hydrogen, for example. The light falls then on a prism. This light emerges from the prism separated and falls on a screen. This spectrum is called the absorption spectrum. The spectrum is a set of discrete dark lines on a bright band of colors. But why do we have these dark lines in the continuous spectrum of white light? This is because the gas absorbs certain photons from the incident white light.
Using Bohr model, we can explain the existence of the dark lines in the absorption spectrum. This is the energy level diagram of a hypothetical atom. So we can conclude that each dark line or missing line in the absorption spectrum corresponds to a wavelength of a certain photon absorbed by the gas atom when it is excited from a lower energy level to a higher energy level. For example, when a photon of energy exactly equals E4 minus E1 hits this atom, this photon is absorbed and the atom makes an upward transition from E1 to E4. Also, when another photon of energy exactly equals E infinity minus E3 hits this atom, this photon is absorbed and the atom makes a transition from E3 to E infinity. Similarly, when a photon of energy exactly equals E3 minus E2 hits this atom, the atom is excited from E2 to E3 and the photon is absorbed. Since the energy of each atom is quantized, therefore, the absorption spectrum is discrete.
We know that all the atoms of the same element have the same set of energy levels. This diagram shows two energy levels, Ex and Ey, of a hypothetical atom. When the atom makes a downward transition from Ey to Ex, it emits a photon of a frequency nu 1. When the atom is excited from Ex to Ey, it absorbs a photon having the same frequency nu 1. What do we conclude? The frequencies or the wavelengths of the missing or dark lines in the absorption spectrum are equal to those of the spectral bright lines in the emission spectrum of the same element. Now, look at the emission and the absorption spectra of the hydrogen atom, where we have the colored lines in the emission spectrum. We have the black lines in the absorption spectrum.
An energy level is called a doublet if it consists of two closely spaced levels. Observe this figure. We have two energy levels very close to each other, so E2 is called a doublet. The absorption and the emission spectra of an atom having such a level include two closely spaced lines called doublet lines. These two lines have very close wavelength. For example, the sodium emission spectrum is dominated by the bright doublet known as the sodium D lines, As we see, the two wavelengths of the two lines are very close to each other, one having a wavelength 588.995 nanometers and the other having a wavelength 589.592 nanometers.